stuff. Just come down to the South. We'll punk you.
Actually, not even just saying it. Just because, like, me and Rock had a great time. Like, as a kid, I always looked up to older actors, just because, and older people in general, I always wanted to be older. I always wanted to hang out with the older kids, always. And so, Rock treated me like a little brother, but like I was also kind of his age, and that was so weird, us having this 10-year age gap, you know what I mean? And I kind of think that he just treated me like a really awesome kid, and I really appreciated that. And, you know, I wasn't necessarily working with the boys on that episode, so Brock made me feel comfortable on set and made me feel not nervous or anything like that. We just had a good time.
Thank you. So,
and
how they kind of pulled him aside. What was your audition experience like for Supernatural?
I don't remember. I really don't. I don't remember. It's that simple. Do you want even another question? Yeah, it was. Oh, not at all. I think, like I said, I think I touched on it earlier very briefly, but every time I go up there, they're so accepting. It's like I never left. It's like my character is a character that they shoot regularly or something. You know, it's weird how, kind everybody is on it. It's not fake. It's confusing though, because everybody's so nice. I'm serious. Everybody's so nice, and they're welcoming, and they just make you, there's no like weird energy in the air. Everybody's just ready to go and make you know, a cool show.
That's awesome. Thank you.
Thank you. Oh, no. Oh, hi, Colin. Huge fan of the show. I'm about to zoom. Just wondering, what was it like to play a character with such a cool older brother? I think you could possibly do like an impression.
I think like you could possibly like do an impression of my older brother if he thinks he's so cool driving his Impala around and stuff. So he's like knocking babes like, yo, what's up, bro? Like, you want to come back to me?
Last year.
Oh, good to see you again.
And I was
wondering, you tweeted me a while ago about how you wanted to see Sam come back and see the Stanford episode and things like that.
Yeah.
Is there any other flashbacks? Because we've seen Sam's first kiss, we've seen his first like real big issue with bullies. Is there anything you want to see him find out or experience as Sam?
We can have Sam experience like anything. Like Sam's first bike ride, Sam's first time on a boat, Sam's first time at the DMV getting his driver's license. Let's do it all. Let's do it all. Let's do it.
Possibly Sam's first one.
Whoa. I like that. I like that.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Hi, my question is, what was it like doing San Diego Comic-Con for the first time, as massively huge as that is?
Oh my gosh, man, that was crazy. I've never seen something like that. That was nuts. It was so cool. It was a whirlwind trip for me. I was there for like literally 24 hours, had to go back and finish an episode of Under the Dome. But it was so much fun. I mean, the amount of people that were there, I mean, I didn't think San Diego could hold that many people. Did it? I mean, you guys could here in Vegas, but San Diego? No, it was so cool. I mean, everybody's walking around like in costumes, supporting their favorite shows or series or animation. The energy is like, and everybody's like happy or drunk. Or both. Everybody's having a great time, and so I just think it's so much fun to get to see, as a fan of like so many different shows as well, it's really cool to get to see them there at Comic-Con as well, because, you know, I don't get to walk around necessarily the whole time, but I get to see like all the different setups and, you know, kind of experience the stuff that the fans go and get to experience, and that's really cool for me.
Well, I think you did a great job with the Under the Dome panel.
Thank you very much.
I just wanted to ask if you always wanted to be a child actor, because I remember you in Smallville. Was that one of the first things you played in?
It was very early on in my career. I've always wanted to be a child actor, and now that I'm starting to be an adult actor, I wish I was still a child actor. No, I've always wanted to be an actor. That's never changed for me. Becoming like the transition between being a young adult or being a teenager and being a young adult kind of came with a lot of decisions like going to college and where and when and et cetera. And that's the decision that I've kind of taken a gap here. I'm maybe gonna take another one, but acting is just like exactly where my heart lies, and I couldn't imagine myself doing anything else, and that's why I'm still doing it, so.
Thank you.
Thank you. Don't be shy.
What was one of the funniest moments you had on set?
I think it's really funny, like whenever you choreograph something, like a fight scene, and it just like doesn't go very well. And it can be bad too if you do too fast, somebody can get hurt. But if it just looks silly, like I remember like trying to fight Dirk the Jerk and him being significantly taller than me, and just like my reach was just like not there. So just like keeping it natural and keeping it just like funny, but whenever there was like those awkward takes, it was just like, we would just like, I would be like, eh! And like laugh it off like at the end. Like, it was just like, it would be silly and we'd know it, so we'd just have a good time doing it. Or just like rolling around like on the mats like while fighting, just like messing around. It's fun.
Thank you.